All right, what's up, boys and girls? Today we have, guess what, another 6ix9ine video because this shit's just not going very well. Apparently, he's expecting to get out early next year. 6ix9ine is convinced he will be out of federal custody at the top of the new year. While testifying against 9 Trey Gangsta Bloods members Anthony Harv, Allo Jemiah Mack last Thursday, the imprisoned artist confirmed that he's expected to be out lockup by the beginning of 2020.
So boom.
When one of Mack's attorneys asked the rapper if he'd be released at the beginning of the next year if the rapper was granted time served. If you get time served, you get out at the beginning of next year, correct? 6ix9ine replied back by saying, correct. I already gave my opinion on that, all that shit. Basically, you know, I'm completely on his side to snitch on people that steal from him, kidnap him, and do all that fucked up shit. Like, of course I'm gonna snitch on you. You know what I'm saying? I already said that in my last video if you haven't seen it already. The main question that people keep asking about the situation since he cooperated and he's gonna get out probably within the next like year or two, or maybe even in a few months, who knows, will he be able to have a career when he gets out? That's the main question that people are asking. Joe Budden talked about it. I've just seen a bunch of people talking about that specific question, and I think it's just because how do you get away with rapping when you just snitched on people, even though they deserve to be snitched on? That's realistic.
Boom.
If what they did is true and they actually did everything, they deserve to be snitched on. But that's not how. Like, if you're a snitch, you're a snitch to some of these people. But my main point here is I don't think that really fucking matters. The only thing that 6ix9ine is going to be concerned about when he gets out is his life. Like, I genuinely think he's going to have to be in witness protection or something, because I don't think he's going to be able to, like, do what he used to do. Genuinely. Ever. They're going to have people, like, trying to either kill him straight up or just beat the shit out of him at all times. Like, people who or in the 9 Trey Bloods, or anything Bloods related, you never know. Like, they might be after this man. Dead ass. It might be that serious. The way I see this is, I feel like majority of 6ix9ine's fan base, who loved his hype ass music that came out, you know what I mean? They loved his energy and all that. It was actually, like, genuinely, like, pretty good music. Really catchy and shit. And that's why it caught on. I think he will still be able to have a career. He either has the best security in the world. I don't know what the fuck this man's gonna do, but I think he could have a career. He's too big not to. I don't see how it could go that wrong unless he just gets killed. I don't know, dude. This shit could get real hairy. Apparently, 6ix9ine wasn't the only snitch. His driver was a paid government informant because they were threatening to literally deport his family, which I think is so fucked up, but I mean, that's just how it works. The government can do fucked up shit to get what they want sometimes, and that happened right here, boys. Rivera testified that he spoke with law enforcement officials about cooperating as a confidential informant following an ICE arrest. Upon his release, he was again enlisted as driver for 6ix9ine. Somehow, 6ix9ine's driver has it all in video of 6ix9ine getting kidnapped and shit. I actually have never seen this yet. This is just beyond fucking stupid shit right here. Biggest clusterfuck ever. The driver of this car has it all in video because he was an informant, bro. The government really shafted these fuckers, dude. Holy shit. It seems in this video that 6ix9ine is like really scared. So he clearly knew something was happening. The ending of this video, I don't know how long it's gonna take, but we're gonna watch some memes.
Niggas empty up!
I'm sorry, what was that?
Blicky got the stiffy up!
Where did the cat come from, dude? Like, what? Hold on. First of all, that's my boy Roy Purdy right there. Second of all, what was going on right there? Mans was squatting in front of a fire hydrant.
Let me get it started.
Why is SpongeBob involved in this so much?
To all the teachers that told me I never amounted to nothing. To all the people that lived above the buildings that I was hustling from that called the police on me when I was just trying to.
Freeway,
get this shit out of here. Bro, look at the fucking, the rainbow teeth and the rainbow hair and everything in this bitch, bro.
6ix9ine's for the kids, you know what I'm saying? We don't promote no gun violence, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Don't promote gun violence. Are you fucking kidding me?
Niggas envy us. Blinky got the stiffy up.
Rest in peace, my fucking ears, bro. Are you kidding me? That was so loud.
6ix9ine.
Let's go!
Bro, this. The editing on these are actually, like, really good. Like, surprisingly.
FBI, open up!
Oh no, academics. What is his life vest? Bro. Man's life vest was around his neck. This is really good editing. Why is this man hitting a watermelon? What is going on? Is that Fat Boy? Someone had to crop him out while he was running with a gun every frame to do these memes. Man's was drinking bleach in this bitch. Bro, alright, that was a good one.
Just a week ago. Boom.
Boom. Grills! This is like impressive editing, like genuinely. What? This is like the best content I've ever seen. Hit subscribe. I love you guys, man. Make sure you follow me on Twitter and Instagram.